It's the final race of the season for the GT4 European Series here at Misano, and the heavens have literally just opened. Just a couple of minutes ago, maybe 20 minutes ago, we had a massive rain shower, and the rain has not yet eased. 20 degrees is the air temperature, track temperature 21.4 degrees, but it's going to be a real challenging race for these guys. The race will start under the safety car because of the very challenging conditions. We've just had another GT race before this, and it was absolutely bone dry. Checkered flag came out, rain chucked it down. The championship has already been decided in the Pro Class. Jelle Beelen and Marcel Noeren won the championship after yesterday finishing in third position, but they were subsequently given a post-race time penalty because of contact they had in the early stages, and as a result they finished in fourth place on the road, but nevertheless they still will win the championship already. You can see the tyre changes going on. We are going to have a safety car start here for this race, and there on the front row of the grid is the 71 car in second place on the grid, and it's Hendrik Still who will be starting that Sophia Motorsport Sinar 1. And, well, it's, if it is Hendrik Still, he's wearing Andreas Gelden's helmet, isn't he? So it looks as though it will be Gelden who will start that race. It's still on the timing screen, so he hasn't switched over his transponder as of yet. On pole position, though, is going to be Pavel Lefterov in the Lotus Evora, the man that was running well yesterday, was closing in on the race leader until he had a suspension failure. He hadn't had any contact for the sort of previous three laps or so, but he will be out racing in this one, which is good to see. So we've got a Bulgarian driver on pole, Bulgarian car on the second row of the grid. On the second position on the grid. Then on third position, we are going to have Carlo Curti in the Maserati starting. And he will be in front of Peter Ebner in the KTM Crossbow that's going to be in fourth on the grid. Although, having said that, it looks as though the Maserati may be missing because there's no sign of it. Oh, no, it's just late. Here it comes. So here comes the Maserati, the official factory entry. And this is a new entry this weekend for Carlo Curti and Lino Curti at their home event. So this is going to be a very interesting race. No doubt about that. Second row are the Curti brothers. Then we've got Ebner and Halleck alongside them in the KTM Crossbow. Then we've got Patrick Zamperini in the Maserati starting behind them in fifth place on the grid. And alongside him is going to be Jelle Beelen in the V8 Racing car, who are already the champions of the series. There you can see the 46 Maserati. Zamperini, who had a great drive in the early stages yesterday before Barry Baxter took over. They still won the AM class in the race yesterday evening, but Baxter had a spin. And as a result, they finished further down the overall order, but still managed to win in their class. So this will be a 50-minute race. There will be a pit stop, as there you see Jelle Beelen, the champions. Beelen and Marcel Noeren winning the title this season after a very strong year, naturally. But what can they do in this final? What for them, I suppose, is a non-championship event. In a way, there's no titles to be decided. Battles on elsewhere in the championship standings, but up at the top, it's all sorted. Just a couple of minutes to go before the race gets going behind the safety car. And I presume the clock will start ticking the moment the safety car pulls away. But we'll wait to see. Normally it would be a rolling start for these guys. But this time it'll be starting behind the safety car because of the downpour that has happened. So they'll get probably at least two laps, I'd have thought, behind the safety car before it peels into the pits and the racing gets underway properly. And that's obviously good news for pole man Pavel Lefterov, because that'll give him a bit of an advantage. He won't have to deal with a start. He can just decide when he wants to start. And Pavel Lefterov has headed off, but the marshal's saying, no, you got to wait for me and my green flag. We're going to give the safety car a bit of a running start. And then you can go only when I tell you to. So away now they pull. And looks as though the rain has stopped. No, it's still going, but it's nowhere near as heavy as it was a little earlier on. So that's giving them, which is good news, I suppose. We want the race to dry out. It's not very easy to change over from wet tyres to slick tyres, because these are all 5-nut hubs that these cars have. So it takes quite a while to change tyres. So you only want to do it if it's absolutely necessary. They don't tend to change tyres in the pit stop window. Make their way around the circuit now. Safety car, you imagine, will gradually pick up speed as the drivers get used to the wet running. They had some wet running on Friday here, but the wet race yesterday was totally dry. Safety car will be in actually at the end of the first lap, so we'll be going racing straight away here in the GT4 European Series. As they make their way around turns 9 and 10, it's Pavel Lefterov on pole. Alongside him on the front row is Andreas Grelden in the Sinar 1. Well, the timing screens say it's Hendrik Still. It seemed as though it was Andreas Grelden who was actually at the wheel of the car. So we'll keep an eye out on that one. Then in third place is going to be the Maserati of Carlo Curti with Peter Ebner in the KTM Crossbow starting behind. First time I've seen a KTM Crossbow race with a roof, actually. Normally they used to be kind of spider designs, didn't they? So into the pits comes the safety car and the race gets underway. Pavel Lefterov through the final corner, gets the race started. Up behind him is Andreas Grelden as the action begins in the final race of the season in the GT4 European Series. And immediately, Gwelden's on the attack. Looking to the outside towards turn one. It's Curti in third place. And the Crossbow of Peter Ebner is behind. And Jeli Bielan is the man trying to make a move straight away, going to the inside of Zamperini and the Maserati as they get on the brakes for turns four. And all the Maseratis not getting stopped, runs out wide. And this is going to be really challenging for these guys. They haven't had a lap at anywhere near racing pace. It was pretty much a formation lap behind the safety car. And a spin, round goes the Maserati, back onto the circuit, full 360, and luckily he doesn't get collected by anyone. But Patrick Zamperini having an early rotation, he's managed to rejoin the race, but it's Lefterov who is leading. And look at this, Peter Ebner trying to get past Curti as they come down into turn 10, not quite close enough. It's Baxter at the wheel rather than Zamperini in that car, so some of the transponders not in the right positions for these drivers. So it's Baxter who started that car. He had a spin yesterday and he's had a spin here today, but leading the way is the Evora of Lefterov. Then in second place it's Andreas Grelden still. All 13 cars running as we come to the end of the first lap. I was a bit worried about Lefterov at the start because he didn't seem to get on with the program coming out of the final corner. And that gave Grelden the opportunity, but he wasn't quite able to get past. As they get onto the brakes into turn one. There we see Ebner in the 15 car, closing in now on the back of the Maserati in front of Curti. Looks to the inside, coming into four, but he's not quite close enough this time to make a move. But it's Pavel Lefterov who's made the break up at the front. 2 seconds clear of Andreas Gvelden. The conditions not getting any easier. The rain did ease a little a couple of minutes ago, but now it seems to have started once again. There's a late look up the inside. Curti manages to hold on. And again, a look up the inside from the 15 car. The Zavoltec Sport KTM Crossbow. Peter Ebner and Sascha Halleck, the two Austrian drivers there. Curti is under some serious pressure now. So Curti under pressure from the 15 car. And oh, that's not good news for the 11 Sofia Motorsport Sinar 1. That's the Mutjens Tertin car, and I think it's Mutjens on another spin, I think, off to the side of it. So it's all getting very busy down there. So Mutjens has had a spin. Try and figure out who the other man to have had a spin was. It might have been the Maserati of Baxter, but we'll keep an eye out on that. Oh, and there's damage. Damage to the front right of Mutjens' car, so maybe there was contact. Jordan Witt's come through. He's in ninth place. They had to go to the back of the pack. Oh no, it was a spin all by himself. And so I don't know where the damage would have come from. Oh, he's going to hit the barrier, isn't he? That's what's happened. He's hit the barrier. Oh, quite hard, actually. And so that's not good news at all. Jordan Witt's up into ninth place because that car had to start from the back of the grid, because in the qualifying session, it was they set their fastest lap under red flag. So as a result, they got all their lap times cancelled. This is the continuing battle over third place, the Maserati versus the KTM Crossbow. And it is Mutjens in the Sinar 1 who has had the spin. So it's still Marcel Nuren who's at the rear of the 69 V8 car, and there is the returning Mutjens. Had a couple of spins yesterday in the race, and had another one today, and that one looks like it will have ended the race for him. Whoa, very out wide goes the Maserati of Curti. And he's still under a lot of pressure from Peter Ebner. Come across the line now. Lefterov leading by 4.4 seconds over Andreas Gvelden in second place. Third place, you've got Curti just up in front of Ebner. So it's Gvelden in second position. In the Sinar 1 that is remaining on the track at the moment. Ebner looking to the inside, trying to get past Curti as they come towards turns 4 and 5. Not quite close enough. Onto the brakes, into the hairpin of 8. Lefterov going quicker and quicker. The Maserati's going off and off. Manages to keep it out of the gravel. But that mistake from Curti means that Peter Ebner's up into second position now. So he'd been trying hard to get past, but then it was sort of handed to him, really. And now his next pressure is going to come from that man there, Marcel Nuren. Less than 40 minutes to go. There you can see the KTM Crossbow then up into second place. Pit stop window opens in 9 minutes' time. Between 30 minutes and 20 minutes is the pit stop window. Through the final corner comes Nuhr, and it is really wet and treacherous out there, isn't it? And that Chevrolet is enjoying the conditions, I think. 5.1 seconds now is the gap from first to second. 5.1 seconds is the gap from second to third as well, now that Andreas Gwelden has managed to get past. There is Bernhard van Orange in the BMW M4 from Ecaris Motorsport. The car that he and Ricardo van der Ende are sharing. The Lefteroff is increasing his advantage rapidly every lap, half a second quicker in the first sector than anyone else. So Ebner up into third spot, Marcel Nuren's in fifth position, Rob Severs is in sixth place at the moment in the number 8 BMW that may be under pressure before too long by Bernhard van Orange. Look at that, as Marcel Nuren tries to get the power down to pass the Maserati of Kurti. He's got a very good drive out of turn 10, looks to the inside line on the run down towards 11. Not quite going to be close enough, very similar straight line speeds there. No progress being made just yet. But they're all starting to queue up now behind Kurti, aren't they? The two BMWs are joining the fray. A track limits warning for Marcel Nuren at turn 6. So he's got to be careful not to push that too hard. They come over the start line again to complete the sixth lap of racing here in Misano. It's the final race of the season for the GT4 European Series. And still the Maserati holding on to third place at the moment. Oh, sorry, fourth place at the moment with Kurti at the wheel. Lefteroff leading the way. Gwelden in second. Third is Peter Ebner. And fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh is this queue here. Is he close enough? Lays on the brakes, going down into the hairpin. And through goes Marcel Nuren up into fourth position. The Maserati drops another place. And Nuren goes through into fourth place then. Kurti drops down to fifth. So now how quickly can the BMW start to put the Maserati under pressure? There's our race leader, Pavel Lefteroff, the Bulgarian, who was close to winning the race yesterday but had a suspension failure and had to retire. But the ASC Bulvato racing team got the car back together again, and now the Evora is leading the way. The gap was 5.1 seconds and it's continuing to extend. It's now 8.3 seconds as the second place Andreas Gwelden comes across the line. Minutes to go in the final GT4 European race of the season. there is the M4. In the hands of Bernhard van Orange at the moment. And at the moment, Curti's holding on to that fifth place reasonably well, not getting too much pressure from Rob Severs behind. Jordan Witt hasn't made as much progress as he would have wanted in the Chevron that won yesterday. Had to start from the back of the grid, and he's only up into ninth position. Blue sky, look at that, coming. But how soon? That's the question. And will these guys need to go on to dry weather tyres? You saw the leading Chevy here of Marcel Nuren trying to get some moisture onto the tyres. Maybe not quite like that by running wide out of turn 10, but he was certainly pulling offline on the run down towards the hairpin. Does he do the same thing here? No, so not as concerned at the moment, Marcel Nuren. And then you got the two Ekris BMWs coming through the spray. So there's the gap now that Peter Ebner's managed to build up in that KTM crossbow over fourth place man Marcel Nuren. Then in fifth place, the Maserati of Curti. Then there in the number eight car, you've got Rob Severs. And Van Orenke is not quite close enough. Now this is a look at Marcel Nuren. Whoa, that's a big one. Goodness me, oh, so that's why he was offline. I saw him about there and thought he was offline cooling his tyres, but what had actually happened was he'd almost taken a first-class ticket to the barriers. Managed to keep it together in the end then, so that explains why he was offline. And again, twitching on the exit of turn six. As there's the look between the two Ekris BMWs. Van Orange unable to quite manage to get past. But that's the fight over sixth position between the M3 and the M4. 32 minutes to go. And now they've got a good run on the Maserati of Curti. So this could be the attack from Rob Severs. He's trying to pull alongside the Maserati, but isn't quite close enough. These cars moving around so much in the damp conditions. Big slide for Van Orange. Keeps it together just about. Curti still running up in front of them at the moment in the Maserati. You feel like the BMWs have got more pace, but can't quite find a way of dealing with that pace and getting through past the Maserati. Across the line they come. Still Lefteroff leading, 10.6 seconds clear up at the front of the order. Then in third place is still Peter Ebner in the Zavotec Sport KTM crossbow. And this battle has all just calmed down a little bit for the time being, hasn't it? There is our race leader, Pavel Lefteroff, who is absolutely flying out there. Superb performance from Lefteroff. The pit stop window is going to open in 20 seconds, so he may decide to come in sooner rather than later. There you've got Marcel Nuren behind. as all five of those, four of those cars come out onto the back straight. And Lefteroff stays out. Pit window is open. But Lefteroff remaining out on the circuit. I don't think it's not going to get dry, is it, before the end of the race? Jordan Witt has had a spin out there and managed to continue in the Chevron. Into the pits, meanwhile, has come Andreas Gwelden to hand over to Hendrik Still in the Sinar 1. We're going to get Marcel Nuren in as well. Yes, in comes Marcel Nuren. Kurti stays out there, and both of the BMW drivers come in too. So Kurti remains out. And the BMW parks up. They'll be handing over to Simon Knapp, and then Ricardo van der Ende will be taking over from the number one BMW. Most of the field in the pits, really. Only Lefteroff, Ebner, Kurti and Witt have stayed out there. As they exit the pit lane now. Actually, that's into the pit lane, isn't it, for Brahms. So it's a minimum pit stop time for these guys, so you can't really, in theory, gain an advantage by having a quicker or slower pit stop. In now comes the leader, Pavel Lefteroff. Oh no, sorry, that was the 16 car. My apologies, not the 6 car. It was Heinz Hallik in the KTM Crossbow. There's our leader, Pavel Lefteroff, and he's staying out again. So he's obviously very happy with the track conditions at the moment and how the car's working for him. Comes across the line again and was the fastest man of anyone in that final sector. Seems as though I think the rain stopped now. Yeah, the rain has stopped here at Misano as these guys all make their way out of the pits. And look at that, Jeli Bielan is now behind the two BMWs. So the BMWs have managed to get past the V8 Racing Chevy during that pit stop. So not good news for Marcel Nuren and Jeli Bielan. It's Bielan now at the wheel, and he'll try and hunt down Ricardo van der Ende and Simon Knapp, the two men in front of him in the Ecarys Motorsport BMWs, with 27 minutes to go. Van der Ende is going to be the first man that he will try and attack. In comes Jordan Witt to hand over to Marcus Clutton. And after their delight from winning yesterday, I think it will be a big ask for them to win this race today. With 26 minutes to go, they're running. They were down in ninth place when the pit stop windows began circulating. Lefteroff carrying on where he left off from the pace yesterday as he comes into the final corner to start lap 13, and we are now halfway through this 50 minute race. Big sideways moment coming out of the final corner for Simon Knapp. He's ahead of van der Ende, who's ahead of Jeli Bielan now, but Bielan's dropping back a little from the BMWs. He's not quite close enough to attack. As out goes Marcus Clutton. Now let's see what Marcus Clutton can do. He's the pro driver in that pairing. And the Chevron was absolutely rapid yesterday. With Clutton at the wheel, so we'll see what happens there. Rejoins the circuit now. comes out just in front of the Duncan Kreisman, I think that is, in the other V8 Racing Chevy in the 96 car. So these two in together, in fact, could be very interesting to watch charge up the order. As they get on the brakes and, there's a big lunge from Kreisman. Goes through, but Clutton sees it coming and just simply cuts back underneath him. Came from a long way back there, Kreisman, but he's managed to hold the position around the outside of the hairpin. So good stuff there. And that's position gained. Into the pits has come the Curtsy brothers, Carlo and Lino. But here's our race leader, Pavel Lefterov. Across the line as Curti makes his way out of the pit. So where are we going to see Curti emerge in all of this? Now Lefterov, of course, hasn't made his pit stop. And he's pretty much got to do it on this next lap, I think. So Curti, where's he going to come out in relation to the BMWs? Keep an eye out, he's going to be behind them. Is he going to be behind the Chevy as well? Not quite. Yeli Beelen comes out behind, but immediately sends it up the inside of Curti and goes past. So Curti is through. 23 minutes to go. Duncan Klausman's been given a track limits warning flag for turn six. Still, it's this Simon Knapp, Ricardo van der Ende battle that isn't really getting any closer at the moment. They've been following each other nose to tail for a while. And, we've got a problem there. A real, but just as I say that, they're now going to go side by side as they come down the back straight. I think that could be Lisette Brahms and Franz Schürrle who has run into problems. But it's still Simon Knapp who's holding on to that lead at the moment. Is there anything Ricardo van der Ende can do? There was contact between car 71 and car 4. Apparently that's Hendrik Still, who has taken over. The race leader's into the pits, but that would only have been Lappery, I think. So race leader into the pits, but he still should emerge in the lead because these guys are all a lap down at the moment. Into the pits comes Pavel Lefterov. And he just has to wait there, really. They have to check the tyre pressures and that's kind of it. See the KTM crossbow, which is now in the hands of Sascha Halleck, and he is now in front of Andreas Gvelden, who's now handed over to Hendrik Still. So Sascha Halleck is up into a net second position, and wonder whether that came about because of the contact, the reported contact anyway, between Still and Brahms. But here's side by side again, Ricardo van der Ende trying to get past his teammate, but still it's Simon Knapp holding the position. Now he's got the inside line into 10. Knapp will try and go around the outside to keep them side by side out onto the back straight, but it'll be the inside for turn 12 for Ricardo van der Ende. Race leader back out on his way, and Knapp is holding the place for the time being as they swing into turn 11. Here at Misano, 20 minutes to go in the GT4 European Championship season. And these three now are all running nose to tail. There's Lefterov emerging from the pits then. Continues to lead the way, and there is the second place battle. And if anything, Well, actually, Sasha Halleck's lost second place, hasn't he? So Sasha Halleck has lost out, or no, he's just massively extended his advantage. My apologies. No, he has lost out. There he is, coming through into the right-hander. Yes, so Sasha Halleck has dropped a position and is down into third. It's the 71 car of Hendrik Stil who's in second place. But Sasha Halleck was in front on the previous tour, so somewhere around that last lap, the overtake has happened. And Halleck drops to third. Then it's Rob Severs and Simon Knapp are running in fourth position. Ricardo van der Ende behind in fifth. And Jelle Bielen in sixth. Duncan Houseman, meanwhile, has just set the fastest final sector of anyone in the 96 car. But there's our race leader, Pavel Lefterov. For ASC Bulvato Racing. And this has been an absolutely commanding drive for him. There you can see the second place car, which actually has Hendrik Stil at the wheel at the moment. In the 71 Sinar 1 from Sofia Motorsport, the Bulgarian team. Hendrik Stil, a German driver. And he's driving it very well. And there's Sasha Halleck, the Austrian. He's running behind in the KTM Crossbow, entered by Zavotec Sport. So they come towards the final turn. So this will give us a true idea of Lefteroff's advantage as he comes across the line. Has it closed in on that last lap? I think it has. 18 seconds is the advantage. Yeah, that last lap, they were slightly quicker, the second and third place cars. Maybe Lefteroff had a little bit of traffic to contend with, but this, meanwhile, is Jelle Bielen right up behind Ricardo van der Ende. Over the line they come. It's the battle over fifth position that van der Ende has in that orange BMW M4. half minutes to go, and car 8 has had 10 seconds added to its total race time. So the Rob Severs and Simon Knapp car is going to have 10 seconds added to its race time, which means that at the moment, as it stands, it would drop from 3rd down to 5th. It's for Article 21.8, so we'll have a look at the rule book and figure out exactly what that's for. These two now are ultimately battling over fourth position. Ricardo van der Ende, as you see Sasha Halleck coming through turn 11. And he is dropping back now from Hendrik Stil. As here's our race leader, Pavel Lefterov. Across the line he comes. And this time it is a 1 minute 55.772, his personal best lap of the race so far. We'll see how much quicker that is than Hendrik Stil as he comes out of the final corner. And across the line in that deep, rumbling Sofia Cars machine. And yeah, the gap extends that time by a second and a half. So Lefterov back on pace now. Sasha Halleck there in third place. And then this is ultimately the battle for fourth position. Okay, so the reason that he's been given Article 21.8 is underspeeding in the pit lane. So holding everyone else up in the pit lane. And we saw that the BMW got in front of the Chevy during the pit stops. And presumably that's they've released the car. And then to make his minimum pit stop time, he's had to drive very slowly out of the pits and gained an advantage through that. So thank you very much for that. And that is the reason that there is a 10-second time penalty added to Rob Severs and Simon Knapp for going too slowly in the pit lane in the mandatory pit stop time. So that will, at the moment, drop them back to fifth position on the road. They're only 3.5 seconds up there. And in fact, it might drop them down to seventh because the 33 car, the 33 Maserati of Dino Curti is on its way to try and join this fight. There it is coming into shot in the background, so that Maserati's got a good amount of pace now. There it is. So 14 minutes to go, and really it's this battle for what will be a net fourth position that's the one to watch, as Ricardo van der Ende holds on to the position at the moment, but he's got a lot of pressure coming from the 69 car of Jelle Bielen. Marcel Nurin, who's taken over as they come through the left-hander, the side, the back of the car, stepping out for Jelle Bielen, who's the pro of these two drivers. So it's Marcel Nurin who started the race as the AM, and the pro now racing is Jelle Bielen. All the pit stop times are okay, is the message from race control, even though the number 8 car achieved that pit stop time by going too slowly in the pits, so they have a 10 second time penalty, and they're holding on to that fourth place at the moment, but that will become most likely seventh position. There's the look up the inside. Through goes Jelle Bielen. He's been chasing Ricardo van der Ende for laps. Van der Ende gets the cutback. Side by side through five, and the BMW holds on. Both back ends step out as they now come through six. Now on the run down towards the hairpin. This is where van der Ende got tapped into a spin yesterday. And he covers the inside line. Oh, out of brakes on the curb there for Jelle Bielen, but van der Ende holds the position for the time being. But Bielen now is trying to start the fight. As they head down the back stretch towards 11. Fantastic fight between these two. And he started to drop back a little now, hasn't he? Jelle Bielen after that attack. Minutes to go. And look how much movement is in that Chevy as they come towards the final corner. How's Marcus Clutton getting along? He's now just a second and a half behind Duncan Houseman in the battle over eighth position. There is the car of Simon Knapp and Rob Sievers, which is going to have a 10-second time penalty, which at the moment would drop it from fourth down to seventh. What a rainbow. Lovely, lovely way to end the season here at Misano. The sun coming out and the racing coming out to match. And whoa, big moment from Ricardo van der Ende. Is that going to be the opportunity? Oh, maybe not. For Jelle Bielen, he himself gets very sideways coming out of turn six. As they get on the brakes. As they come out of eight now. And van der Ende seems reasonably comfortable, unless he makes a small mistake. I know that seems an obvious thing to say, but in general he's got the pace to stay in front, but just the slightest mistake. And the Chevy will be on his tail. Meanwhile, it's 3.1 seconds now between second and third, so that battle has stabilised, really. Pavel Lefteroff, the race leader, is absolutely miles up the road. He's got a massive advantage, and it's 24 seconds now. There's Sascha Halyk, running in third, 3.5 seconds behind Hendrik Still. So that advantage has gained a little bit. Less than 10 minutes left now, and Ricardo van der Ende is still holding on to that fifth spot. As they come up towards turns four and five, they're both starting to close in again on Simon Knapp, who, despite that 10-second penalty, is losing out. Despite having the advantage over these two in the early part of this stint, they come down the straight towards the hairpin. Again, van der Ende goes a little wide. Does that give an opportunity for Yerli Beelen? Not at the moment, as they go nose to tail up towards turn 10. Out onto the back stretch. You can see how quickly they've closed in on Simon Knapp. And he's feeling the need to go a little bit defensive going in there. Here's van der Ende, and as a result, he runs out a bit wide. Hendrik Stills just at the fastest middle sector of anyone on this tour. Simon Knapp's pace is dropping away, isn't it, with 8 minutes left. Through the final corner again. This is to complete their 20th lap of racing in the final race of the season in the GT4 European Series. And no doubt these guys will all be going for it again when the season gets underway next year for 2016. But it's Pavel Lefterov who has the lead. 25 seconds clear now of the rest of the pack. Now, can van der Ende be a little bit neater through here? Not quite. This is absolutely fantastic stuff, isn't it? As they slide sideways around the circuit. And he's feeling a bit under pressure, van der Ende, so he goes defensive on the run down into turn eight. And look at the back end of that Chevy flicking out as he gets on the brakes. He's got a very good cutback, though. Will he be able to quite get alongside? No, but this will give him a great advantage on the run out through 10. So Yerli Beelen waiting for it, cutting back, getting on the power. Good stuff from Beelen. And now this could be the opportunity. They're side by side as they come down towards turn 11. Beelen is slightly in front as they come to the turning point, and I think that should be job done for Yerli Beelen. He goes through in the V8 Racing Chevy Camaro GT4. And that is now a net fourth place for him, because the car up in front, Simon Knapp, has a 10-place time penalty. Car one, meanwhile, which is Ricardo van der Ende, has been given a warning for abusing track limits. And whoa, big slide out of the final corner for Yerli Beelen. Now he's got that fifth position, which is a net fourth because of the 10-second time penalty that will be applied to the car in front. And now van der Ende wants to get back. Whoa, lobs it up the inside at turn two. Back end comes out, holds it, but that'll cost him momentum. Great action in the GT4 European Series here. Pavel Lefterov leading 26 seconds up the road. Sasha Halek gained about 7/10 of a second in the battle for second position on that last lap. It might be a little too late. But there's Pavel Lefterov with 5 minutes left. He is bossing this one. There is the second place battle. It's still in second place, but it's Sasha Halek who's in third. and lapping certainly quicker in the first sector by some 7/10 of a second. The personal bests so far in the first and second sectors for Sascha Halek. Four and a half minutes left. What's the gap come down to this time? It's come down by another 1.1 seconds, so it's just 1.7 seconds between the pair of them now. This is very good driving from Sascha Halek. He's really in the zone. Meanwhile, here's Jelle Bielen. He's caught up to the back of Simon Knapp. Gets the drive out of the final corner, and he's going to challenge the BMW. Not close enough into turn one. Using all of the curb and a little more in turn two. Darting around as the sun comes out here in Misano. This is the second place battle. But here again, on the run down to the hairpin, comes the attack. Knapp has to go defensive. Jelle Bielen goes wide to try and get the better drive out. This is exactly how it all lined up for his move on the previous BMW of Van der Ende. He'll hold the outside line, get on the brakes earlier, and try and cut back to the inside. Or he'll try and go all the way around the outside at turn 10. Great stuff from Jelle Bielen. He goes around the outside of Simon Knapp and up into fourth place. What a move that was from the V8 Racing driver. Jelle Bielen up into fourth spot. And no response there held for Simon Knapp. And that is fourth place on the road, which is always nice. He probably would have had fourth place anyway because of the penalty, the 10-second penalty that's going to be given to the BMW. But now it's nose to tail for the second place. At the moment, it's being held by Hendrik Still in the Sin R1. But here comes Sascha Halek up the inside into four. And as it's drying, perhaps, Sascha Halek is feeling more comfortable in the car. He gets the move done on the inside. Still tries to get the cutback. They're going to go side by side through six. Still, it will be who will have the better drive out of six, but he got a little bit out of shape. And as a result, it's Sascha Halek who has the advantage. Goes defensive into the hairpin, both scrabbling for grip. But Halek has consolidated that second place now. Goodness me. Fantastic stuff as they fight it out for second position. Halek goes in, loses the second place now. I thought he would consolidate it because he'd managed to get in front, having closed in so rapidly. Not to be just yet. Through turn 11. Halek trying to find the inside line again. Looks to the inside into the 14 corner, but he's not close enough. The KTM Crossbow trying to get past the Sin R1 in front. Good drive this from Sascha Halek. As they come through now to start the penultimate lap of the race. Lights flashing on Sascha Halek's car, trying to distract Hendrik Still in front. Darting one way, darting the other way. Will he be able to find the way past managed it before. Through turn six, they come absolutely nose to tail. Halleck takes more speed, runs out a little wider. Flashing his light still to try and distract, still in front of him. Into the hairpin, still goes in quite deep. Halleck tries to get the drive off, isn't able to do anything about it. There's our leader though, Pavel Lefterov, as he comes up to the final corner to start the final lap of the race. Through the left-hander he comes. And he now starts the final lap. There you can see one Giro to go. What a performance this has been from Pavel Lefterov, you have to say. Really splendid stuff. Still is holding on to second position. But they are now about to start their final lap of the race. Nose to tail. Where can Sascha Halleck find the room to get past? Marcus Clutton's just set the fastest middle sector of anyone, but he's only managed to climb up to eighth position in the Chevron. Halleck's got so much more traction getting out of the corners, hasn't he? That's where he seems to really take the speed, a differential to Hendrik Still. There's the cutback. Oh, big sideways moment from Still, and Halleck's through. Well, we said it was on traction, and that's pretty much what's just happened. So Halleck, can he now hold on? Windscreen wipers going on Hendrik Still's car, but I don't think that's because of any more rain. But here now is our race leader, Pavel Lefterov. He's going to win overall and in the AM class. It's been a magnificent drive from Lefterov. And the final round, the final race in the GT4 European Series of 2015 is going to be won by Pavel Lefterov in the Lotus Evora. Ecstatic with that. He hasn't got to the line yet. There we go. Now he can relax as he stops almost on the line. And he's over the moon with that one. Here comes Sascha Halleck, and he is going to win in the Pro class. As he comes through the final corner. And Sascha Halleck, after a great drive, finishes second overall and wins his class. The delight on the pit wall there for the Zavatek Sport team. Then we're going to have Jeli Beelen. Through the final turn, a hard-fought race for Jeli Beelen. Already the champions, but they have now consolidated that with a final podium. Simon Knapp's going to finish, oh look at that, just in front of Duncan Houseman as they come across the line. Good drive from Houseman to return up the order, but Knapp will be given a 10 second penalty. Out of the final corner comes Kurti, who we thought would have a little bit more pace. They were closing in the early stages of that stint, but not able to get through in the end. And here is the other KTM crossbow of Heinz Halleck, the father of Sascha Halleck. And he's going to finish, I think, third in his class, because the 46 Maserati of Patrick Zamperini and Barry Baxter are going to be the men to finish 10th overall and second in class, although they haven't come across the line yet. Oh, there they are coming out of the final corner. So is that Heinz Halleck? No, he's a lap down. There we go. So he finishes third, and then that car next across the line finishes in second with Zamperini at the wheel. But it's the win for Pavel Lefterov. Great performance from the Bulgarian, the winner in Misano, the winner of the final race of the season. I think he'll be more than satisfied with that. And what a superb drive it was. He's been great here all weekend. Had the pace all weekend. Was let down by the car yesterday, but managed to get it back together. Here's a look at the results then. And it's Pavel Lefterov who wins with a 28-second advantage in the end over Ebner and Halek, who managed to take that second spot on the final lap ahead of Still and Gueldum. Then we had Jelibinen and Marcel Nurin, already the champions, finishing in fourth place. Ebner and Halek's second position is also the pro class win. Then you'll see that the 8 car of Simon Knapp and Rob Severs was dropped down to 8th position for underspeeding in the pit lane. Then we've got the Curti brothers in 9th position, Zamperini and Baxter finishing 2nd in the AM class ahead of Heinz Halleck. And we saw that Lisette Brahms and Franz Verschuer ran into troubles, I think after some contact, and they had to retire from the race, as did Olivier Mutjens before Peter Terting could even get in the car. So they make their way around. And there is the second place car of Sascha Halleck. And the third place car of Hendrik Still doesn't really know where he's meant to park it. And they're bringing him down there anyway. Somewhere out there will be Pavel Lefterov, our race winner, who has slowly come back to the pits to enjoy his victory lap. And here he is now. So great stuff from Pavel Lefterov. A really strong drive from the Bulgarian. And he is absolutely over the moon with that one, as he congratulates his team and is congratulated by his team. The ASC Bulvato Racing team with the Lotus Evora. And he is absolutely ecstatic to have taken victory. As I say, almost took victory yesterday, but it just got away from him when the car let him down. But now he has certainly made amends today, Pavel Lefterov. And the Bulgarian will be over the moon, no doubt, with that victory, winning his class as well by more than a minute, with Barry Baxter finishing down in 10th place overall. And he will make his way to the podium after all the congratulations are done, which might take a while after a performance as strong as that one. Second place and the winner in the pro class went the way of the 15 car of Sascha Halleck. So no doubt Sascha will be satisfied to win the class at the final race of the season. And we're having the photos already down underneath the podium before they even get up onto the podium. And delight for the Lotus Evora squad and the whole ASC Bulvato Racing team. And what a great race to end the GT4 European Series season. When the race got underway, it was under safety car conditions, and Pavel Lefterov initially looked like he was going to be under pressure from Andreas Gueldin, but Lefterov managed to consolidate the lead and pull away. In third place in the opening stages was the Maserati of the Curti brothers, but they would soon lose time. There was a spin, and that was for Olivier Mutjens. He crashed the car and knocked the Sin 1 out of the race. A big tank slapper moment for the Chevy when it was in the hands of Marcel Nuren, but he managed to keep it together and he would soon be put under pressure. The Chevron had a quiet race after winning yesterday, and then when Jeli Bielan took over, he was starting to make positions up, going past the Curti brothers, and then would start to close down on the BMWs in front. Into the pits came the race leader, and there was no real dramas there, but this was the three-way fight that continued throughout the remainder of the race, whilst Pavel Lefterov rejoined in the Lotus Evora, comfortably in the clear. And then there was the move from Jeli Bielan getting up the inside, but Ricardo van der Ende in the 1 BMW M4 got the cutback and retook the position. And so Jelle Bieland tried again, this time getting the drive out of the hairpin. And that subsequently meant he managed to get the inside line into turn 11. And there was job done. And that put him up into fifth position. There was still the fourth place car to try and get past, as Van der Ende had a big slide, almost knocking himself out of contention. But then there was just the battle of the fourth place battle to be dealt with, and the second place battle as well. Sascha Halleck lunging one up the inside, went in a little bit too deep, and that allowed Hendrik Still back through. But eventually Halleck made the move stick and brought the KTM crossbow for he and Peter Ebner home in second position at the end of the race. But it was the final victory of the season for the number 6 ASC Bulvato Racing Lotus Evora of Pavel Lefterov. The Bulgarian, absolutely elated, just about managed to make it to the chequered flag before he got too excited and stopped. Took the chequered flag, took the race victory, and will now be heading out onto the podium in a couple of moments' time. As they just have some interviews with the Dutch TV crew, and then they'll be pushed out onto the podium to spray the champagne once more. And there'll be the Pro Podium and the Am Podium. And there you can see Pavel Lefterov having his interview over on the right-hand side. Sascha Halleck there just coming through the doors. The bespectacled Austrian. And a good drive from him and Peter Ebner, the two Austrian drivers, doing a good job. As the weather has picked up now since the start of the GT4 European Series race, hasn't it? A much more pleasant day. Still quite a bit of wind in the air, as you can see from the trees, but this Misano circuit, about 5 kilometres inland from the Adriatic coast, is a wonderful venue to come to for motorsport. And the GT4 European Series raced here last year as well, and had its first night race here last season, and had a night race here last night too, which was won by the 44 Chevron Cars entry of Marcus Clutton and Jordan Witt, but they had to start from the back today, and as a result never really managed to get towards the front of the order. So just waiting for the podium procedures to get underway, which should be any moment. And I think we'll see a very happy Pavel Lefterov on the top step. As far as the championship is concerned, it was wrapped up yesterday by Jelle Bieland and Marcel Nuren. So they were very satisfied to take the title after a long season that saw them start at Nagaro, went to Spa, Nürburgring, and a few other venues over the course of the year. Zandvoort, of course, as well. And it's Marcel Nuren and Jelle Bieland who win the title and got a third place in their pro class in this one. That's why they're there on the left-hand side waiting for their chance to go onto the podium for their third place trophies. And there you can see Peter Ebner with his back towards us, having a chat to Sascha Halleck, discussing that fight for second position, which they came out on top of in the end. And Sascha Halleck, Peter Ebner in the pro class in the KTM crossbow. And it looks as though we're nearly ready for the podium procedure to get underway. And there is Pavel Lefterov on the right of screen. Marcel Nuren with his back to us. Talking to Rick, the PR for the championship. So a round of applause for, I think it's for Heinz Halleck, who is coming out, because he finished third in the AM class. Second in the AM class is Barry Baxter and Patrick Zamperini. Zamperini at his home race onto the second step of the podium alongside Barry Baxter. They won their class yesterday, but it's Pavel Lefterov who wins his class and wins the race overall here in Misano, the final round of the season in the GT4 European Series. The ASC Bulvato Racing Team taking victory. The Bulgarian national anthem then on the podium for Pavel Lefterov. And the trophies being awarded, there's Heinz Halleck. Third place for him, another podium after finishing on the podium yesterday. He was third in class yesterday as well. Second place after their win yesterday means a good end to the season for Barry Baxter and Patrick Zamperini. But it's the top step for Pavel Lefterov, the winner of the final race in the GT4 European Series and the winner in the AM class as well. And an award too for the ASC Bulvatov Racing Team in their Lotus Evora GT4 as they pose for the photographs on the podium. And then it'll be time for the pro podium, which bizarrely won't see our overall winner, because Pavel Lefterov managed to do it there. Are we going to have champagne, or are they? No, they're not too bothered about champagne. They'll just save it and drink it. Seems like the wisest option. So, oh no, they are spraying it, but off the side of the podium. So a bit of champagne sprayage going on. And there are the pro drivers waiting to go out onto the podium. A thumbs up there from Peter Ebner, the winner of the pro class. Congratulations all around, and they will be going out onto the podium in a couple of moments' time as they get some more champagne ready. There you can see our class winners there in the middle. Then Hendrik Stil and Andreas Guelden are the men to the left as we look at it, and then third in class Jeli Bielen and Marcel Nuren on the right hand side, who now they've got the championship wrapped up, I think are happy to see the season end and look forward to next season in their V8 Racing Chevrolets. But a good drive from particular Sascha Halleck, really. He had to haul in about a 4 or 5 second deficit to the second place car of the Sinar 1 from Sofia Motorsport. He managed to haul it in, make the overtake, and made the move stick. Experienced racer Sascha Halleck, he's raced in the Blancpain Sprint Series, the FIA GT Series over the past few years, mainly with the Grasser Racing Team, the Austrian entrant. And now he's just waiting for his step on the podium. He's made a mess of his overalls, hasn't he, down on his legs. Not the pristine white that Peter Ebner's are. As they wait for the final pro podium of the season to get underway. And a very happy Sascha Halleck, I think we'll see on the top step. Had to work very hard to take that victory. So the Zavotta Sport pairing are about to take to the top step of the podium in a couple of moments' time. Jeli Bielen and Marcel Nuren finishing in third place in the end, which I think will frustrate them a little bit. The wet weather didn't really seem to suit their car on this occasion. And there is Jeli Bielen and Marcel Nuren out onto the podium. It's third position for them. It's the end of the season, and it's the championship title. Second place for Hendrik Stil and Andreas Guelden. Delighted with that. You go on to the second step, chaps. It's over the other side. But Sascha Halleck and Peter Ebner are the men who will stand on the top step of the podium. They know where that is. So the top step of the podium for Sascha Halleck and Peter Ebner. The Austrians on the top step in Italy. And Marcel Nurin helping himself to the trophy there. But it's victory in the championship overall for them, and third place. Now let's see if these guys know. Yeah, they know what to do with the trophies. That's good, as they hold them aloft. A second place finish. Great performance for Hendrik Still and Andreas Gvelden. But the winners, Sascha Halyk and Peter Ebner, on the top step of the podium here in Misano. They win the final race in the pro class. Anyway, they finish second overall, but they win the final pro class event in the GT4 European Series. They're going to spray the champagne as they soak Jelle Bielen. And they've got their champagne open as well. So apart from the missed step, everything else on the podium went well for Hendrik Still and Andreas Gvelden. But it's Sascha Halyk and Peter Ebner who are on the top step, taking victory in the GT4 European Series. Thank you very much for joining us throughout the season. We'll be back in 2016 for more action from the GT4 European Series.